So, brand new MacBook Pros have just been announced at the latest Apple October Unleashed event. At this event, we saw a brand new 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook Pro, but we also saw the brand new M1 Pro and the M1 Max chipset. One question a lot of people are already asking was, what is the difference between the M1 Pro and the M1 Max? Well, today I'm going to answer what the differences are between those chipsets and which one you should pick for you. Also, at the same time, I'm going to show you the different kind of options you can pick for your MacBook Pro on the Apple website. Hi guys, it's Matt here. So that's right, we've got these brand new MacBook Pros and we've also got these brand new chipsets, the M1 Pro and also the M1 Max. And they're absolutely screamers in performance. They're absolute beasts. So today I want to show you guys the kind of difference between an M1 Pro and an M1 Max. So first of all, the M1 Pro and the M1 Max is based on the architecture of the original M1 chipset, what came out last year in 2020. So basically this means the kind of single core kind of speed you can expect will be very, very similar across the board. However, for multi-core score, this is where the big changes are going to be. The M1 Pro and the M1 Max are significantly faster compared to the original M1's multi-core performance. Don't get me wrong, the M1 chip is still a fantastic chip out there. And if you're looking to get yourself kind of into the Apple market and getting yourself your first kind of MacBook Pro or your kind of first MacBook, getting yourself an M1 Mac is totally worthwhile in getting. However, for people who are creators like myself, who do like video creating, you should look into getting yourself kind of an M1 Pro or an M1 Max chipset inside. Well, first of all, let's cover the main differences, and the best way to do this is actually talk about the two chipsets. So let's first of all talk about the M1 Pro first of all. So the architecture of M1 Pro is significantly different to the M1 chipset. So starting off with the CPU, where M1 actually had an 8-core CPU, and this had 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores, M1 Pro actually has 2 efficiency cores and 8 performance cores, making a total of 10 cores. It is claimed that the M1 Pro, just the CPU, is 70% faster than the M1 chipset, and that is amazing straight away. Then, for the actual graphics element, the GPU, comes with 16 cores. This is double the amount of cores that you get in the M1 GPU, which only has 8 cores. And as you can expect, this is 2 times or double the amount of power, of graphics power, what you get inside M1, what again is absolutely amazing to have. There are other features as well to look out for here with M1 Pro, and that is, for example, the memory bandwidth is 200 gigabytes, and also at the same time, the actual amount of monitors that you can plug into an M1 Pro MacBook Pro is that you can plug in 2 monitors at the same time if you really want to do that. There is also an improved media engine compared to what you get inside the M1, and also you get a better machine learning experience so that your actual MacBook Pro can work things out much more quicker compared to M1. So as you can see, compared to the original M1, the M1 Pro is absolutely phenomenal in its performance. However, you do have the M1 Max as well. Let's talk about the M1 Max now and compare that to the M1 Pro and what you're going to be getting if you buy this chipset over the M1 Pro.
So starting with the actual CPU of the M1 Max, you can see here that generally it's basically same as the M1 Pro. We have a 10 core setup again, and this is the 2 efficiency cores and also the 8 performance cores. But it's the GPU where things change quite a bit here. So with the GPU compared to the M1 Pro, with the M1 Max, you actually now get 32 cores in the GPU. Well, it's absolutely amazing. It is double the amount what you get inside the M1 Pro, and that is also 4 times the amount what you actually get with the original M1 chipset. But there are also a few other changes with the M1 Max. For example, you can actually plug in 4 external monitors compared to the 2 external monitors on the M1 Pro. Also, at the same time, you now also get 400 gigabytes of bandwidth, what is double the 200 gigabytes of bandwidth on the M1 Pro. Then finally, you also have the ability to configure up to 64 gigabytes of RAM, where M1 Pro only goes up to 32 gigabytes of RAM.
So you can see that the M1 Max is an ultimate beast of a chipset inside. It's absolutely incredible. Don't get me wrong, the M1 Pro is still absolutely amazing. And for most amateur kind of professionals out there, the M1 Pro is going to be more than enough what you need. Compared to the last generation MacBook Pros, the higher tier 13-inch, and also even the i9 MacBook Pro 16-inch, this is way out of its class for the M1 Pro. But the M1 Max is even better and even stronger. But what I want to do now for you guys is I want to show you the different kind of versions of the M1 Pro and the M1 Max and the kind of sort of different kind of configure options that you can pick from, and also the kind of prices that it will chuck out on Apple's website. Because I can tell you now, even though these chipsets are super powerful and super efficient, they do cost quite a bit to buy. Well, let's go have a look at that. And let's first of all configure up a MacBook Pro 14-inch with an M1 Pro.
So here we are on Apple's website. I'm actually on the American version of this website. I'm British myself, but just for this example, I'm going to be sticking around on the American site. So what I've done is I've gone to the MacBook Pro section to order one. And as you can see here now, you've got the options of a 13-inch, 14-inch, and the new 16-inch as well. So if we selected the 14-inch, what we're on, we can see we have two kind of options here straight away. And you can see we can configure things around any way we like them. Now, the first one I'm going to go into is actually this first one here, the first 14-inch MacBook Pro. So I'm going to select on this one. Now, the first thing you may have noticed straight away is the amount of cores that are here. This is something that Apple didn't actually talk about. And basically, what they have actually created is another M1 Pro chipset. And this chipset has an 8-core CPU. And what actually that 8-core CPU is built from is that you've got 2 efficiency cores and you've got 6 performance cores. But then for the GPU, you've actually got a 14-core GPU. Now, straight away, you have noticed this is a drop in 2 cores of CPU cores for the performance and a drop of 2 cores for the GPU core. And you're probably wondering why this is. And the main reason why this is Apple actually, when they make their chipsets, some of them are actually known to fail, some of the cores. And what this is known as, this is known as core binning. And what Apple would like to do is they don't want to chuck away these chips, so they sell them a bit more cheaper. And you guys can actually buy them with this. It doesn't mean that the other cores are going to break or anything. It just basically means during the manufacturing process, because it's so small, it's on a 5-nanometer die, that sometimes the chips can go a little bit wrong. They don't want to get rid of them, so they offer it up to you guys to actually buy, and it's really, really cool still. So these chips here, like I said, you've got an 8-core CPU and a 14-core GPU, and they're still really, really good. You can have this with 16 gigabytes of RAM, and if I believe I'm right here, you can actually change up to 32 gigabytes of RAM. And you can see here the price went up straight away. You've also got the options here to change your actual storage, so you get a standard 512 gigabytes of SSD, but you can configure this all the way up to 8 terabytes. The next step up, if we just put this back to 16 gigabytes and we change this back here to 512 gigabytes, is that we can actually change this to the M1 Pro 10-core, the 10-core that we know about. So as you can see here, this is the 10-core CPU, and you also this time though get the 14-core GPU. So again, this is less, again, this is a bin version of the GPU, but you can actually get the higher CPU. You can do all those kind of same configurations of changing your storage around, and you can also change your RAM amount. The next option after this is the one that Apple have basically talked about, and the one I've mainly talked about here in this video, and this is the 10-core CPU. So this is your 2 efficiency cores, and then also your 10 performance core and the 16-core GPU. So you can select this as one of your options, and again, you can configure this up to 32 gigabytes of RAM or all the way up to 8 terabytes SSD. The next option, what you can pick against, is the actual Apple M1 Max. And even with this, there are some changes.
So guys, just quickly as we're going through all the different options here, this channel is doing a giveaway right now, and it is for this. It is for an iPhone 13 Pro Max. And I'm going to be giving away this iPhone 13 Pro Max, what's 128GB storage option with Sierra Blue, to one lucky subscriber when we get over 300,000 subscribers. And all I want to know from you guys is, within the next year, what Apple gear are you planning to buy? Put it down in the comments below, and then when we get over 300,000 subscribers, I'm going to be picking one lucky subscriber who is going to get their hands on this brand new iPhone 13 Pro Max. But make sure, guys, that you have subscribed to this channel and hit that notification bell, because when we get over that 300,000 figure, I'll be revealing who the winner is at that time, not any sooner, and you'll want to get that notification to find out if you're going to be that lucky winner. Also, guys, at the same time as well, I must just mention that if you do get a kind of a spam kind of message or comment saying you've won a prize or you've won something before we hit over 300,000 subscribers, it is not me. Unfortunately, it's a scammer out there. Also, at the same time as well, I just want to quickly mention, if you're enjoying this video so far, please do also press the like button. Well, let's get back to the main video.
So again, you get that 10-core CPU, but this time you only get a 24-core GPU. So again, some of those cores have been binned, and so you're getting a little bit less than that actual 32-core GPU. So this is kind of like a midway between that 16 and 32. It's really good that actually Apple offer this. You can choose between those options. So you can actually have a 24-core GPU in your Apple M1 Max if you really wanted to do that. As standard, this comes with 32GB. Of RAM, but you can configure it up to 64GB of RAM if you wanted to, and again with the storage, the same options are available. You can configure this all the way up to 8TB if you really wanted to. And then finally, the last option is the beast of them all. So this is the Apple M1 Max with 10-core CPUs we've talked about, but this time you get the 32-core GPU. This is the absolute maximum chipset you can buy out there. Again, you can configure this with 64GB of RAM if you wanted to, and all the way up to 8TB. And if I selected this, you can see this can get quite expensive straight away.
So that's the M1 Pro and the M1 Max in a 14-inch MacBook Pro. Let's now look at the 16-inch MacBook Pro and the options that we have right there.
So I'm back on the main website again. I'm on the main MacBook Pro, but this time I'm going to select the 16-inch MacBook Pros. And as you can see, there's lots of different options that you can pick here, and you can configure them all up to the sort of maximum kind of spec. So I'm actually going to pick this one here, the lowest spec one of the 16-inch, and we're just going to open that up straight away. And as you can see here, the first kind of option that you can have is that you can have yourself here an Apple M1 Pro 10-core CPU and a 16-core GPU. Now, you might have noticed straight away, if I scroll down here, you do not actually have a binned version of that M1 Pro with just 8 cores inside it, the 2 efficiency cores and also the 6 performance cores. You just get the choice of that one with the 10-core CPU. But what you also get with that M1 Pro is that you also get the 16-core GPU. So no GPU cores have been binned either. So you can have that, and that starts with 16GB of RAM. You can configure that up to 32GB of RAM, and then storage starts at 512GB SSD, and you can select an 8TB, and you can select your 32GB of storage, you can see here, and you can pick those options. The next option, what you can actually select, is this one here. You actually move straight into M1 Max territory. So there's only one option for M1 Pro on the 16-inch MacBook Pro. So yeah, that is a bit different compared to the MacBook Pro 14-inch. You've only just got one selection of an M1 Pro. But let's select the M1 Max. And straight away, you can see up here, we get that 10-core CPU again, but we get that binned GPU. So we only get a 24-core GPU, as you can see right here. And again, you can configure that from 32GB up to 64GB and all those storage configurations. And then the last one is that top dog M1 Max. So I'm just going to select that one there. And as you can see, you get that 10-core CPU. And as I've said before, 2 efficiency cores, 8 performance cores, and a 32-core GPU. This is basically identical to that top layer Apple M1 Max what's in the 14-inch MacBook Pro, but obviously you're in a larger MacBook Pro. And then again, you can select either 32GB or 64GB of storage, and then you can select all the way up to 8TB of storage as well. So if I select all those options, you can see it costs over $6,000 for this MacBook Pro if you select all the top options.
So there we have it. Those are the kind of sort of configurations that you can pick for the 16-inch MacBook Pro and the 14-inch MacBook Pro. You can pick some really incredible bits and pieces there. You can pick the top spec 32GB of RAM, 32-core, the 10-core CPU. You can pick that 8TB SSD drive. It's absolutely crazy in what you can go up to, and the performance is going to be absolutely screaming when you get it. But remember, guys, don't go too crazy in that you've got to pick the absolute best. Remember that picking even lower specs most likely will probably be able to do the jobs that you want to do. Remember also that the M1 chipset, for example, generally speaking, like in Final Cut Pro, is much more efficient and actually faster than the older i9 MacBook Pro 16-inch model out there. And that was just the M1 chipset inside. So remember, do not go too crazy. Well, guys, it's time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, please also do hit that subscribe button followed by that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye-bye now.